Hello, 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 and welcome to Queen's Public Library's program, where we're going to be covering TumbleBooks and World Book Online in relation to Halloween. And so my name is Miss Jo from Hunters Point Library. And so before we officially get started, I wanted to give just a few pointers about some of the new stuff that is happening at QPL. So first, QPL is open for to-go service, which is to pick up and return materials at several locations. And if you're interested in finding out more or want to learn about other virtual QPL programs, accessing digital services, getting an e-card, or making a donation to support the library, please visit queenslibrary.org. As always, our digital materials are available 24/7 from anywhere with an internet connection. And so let's just get right into it. So as I mentioned, today we are going to be covering World Book Online and TumbleBooks, and we're gonna be focusing on Halloween because it's so close and it's gonna be happening very soon. So I hope you have some ideas of some Halloween costumes that you are thinking of. If you need help thinking of a Halloween costume, some of the topics we're gonna be covering today might help spark some ideas. If you have a Halloween costume that you already have set, please write it in the comments, and I would love to hear what you guys are planning to dress up this year. So first, just to cover some of the information, we're gonna go over World Book Online first. So to go over World Book Online, you have to go to first queenslibrary.org, and we're gonna click research. So under research, you're gonna click the second tab called Research Databases. And you're going to scroll down once you get to the new page. You're going to scroll down all the way down to the bottom, where you're going to see World Book Online is the last one. And so once you find it, we're just going to click Search Within Database. So let's all click that together. Now, World Book Online, as you notice, I didn't have to sign into my library account. And so this is just something that if you have access to queenslibrary.org, you don't need to sign in. You can just go right into the database. And so we're gonna go through three different sections that all will help you learn about Halloween and maybe give you some tips and ideas of what you want to dress up this year for the upcoming holiday. So first we're gonna go to early learning. So we're gonna go through some of the things for the younger kids, some of the older kids, and some of the kids just right in between in those age groups. So let's go to early learning first. So as you see, when you click early learning, what is going to happen is you are going, perfect. When you go into early learning, what's going to happen is you're going to see various fun images and as well as these four tabs on the top. And so one of the things we're going to do is, as you can scroll, you see things like sea creatures, you see things like creepy crawlies, wild animals, animal homes, and weather, and other various things. So but for today, as we're talking about things you would like to potentially dress up as on Halloween, we're going to go to this one called People at Work. So once you scroll through, as you can see through those two buttons at the bottom, you just click the image and you're going to see this whole new page called, so this one's called People at Work. And so as you can see, there's various people and their positions. So for instance, we have house to house workers, jobs that protect people, health professionals, and many, many more. And so what happens is I'm going to click on teacher because the school year has just started. And so, for instance, if we click on one, this tile called for teachers, we're going to click that. And you're going to notice we get some information about being a teacher. So, for instance, if you're thinking, oh, for Halloween, I really am thinking I want to be a teacher. This can cover some of those things that teachers do in the classroom. If you ever want to listen to it versus reading it, you can always click these microphones over here, and that will help. So when you're going through between the different pages, you always just click the arrows at the bottom. So for instance, this one talks about how maps are in the classroom. A map helps us find different places around the world. A whiteboard, a teacher writes a lesson on a whiteboard. So maybe part of your Halloween costume, if you want to hold a small whiteboard, that could also work as well. So to X out of this, you would just click the big X in the right-hand corner. Click that for me. And we go back to the previous page we were at. Now, we'll scroll down. And you'll notice also, for instance, if you are thinking, okay, I want to be a teacher, but what are some things that some other people do? What do they do in the field? So you can go to videos down here where you can watch and see various things for this particular part for people at work, different types of things that they do at work. And then also, if you're like me and you like games, you can play some games in this platform as well related to the topic. Lastly, as I scroll down, you're gonna see stories. So if you wanna read some stories related to people at work, this is where you can find them. And also pictures too as well. Scroll down even more and you get activities. So going through all of this, for when you click on those icons, you can get activities, you can get pictures, you can get stories, you can get games, you can get videos, and you can get information about specific types of jobs that people do. Now, you must be wondering, you know, maybe I don't want to dress up as a person at work. I want to dress up as something else. So how do we get back to that previous page? What we will do is we will click the home button right over here. And you're going to notice that we are back to where we were before. Now, I know, you know, for myself this year, I was thinking I might dress up as a dinosaur, but now the real question is what type of dinosaur will I be dressing as? And so once again, we click on the arrows at the bottom and we see dinosaur. We're gonna click on this dinosaur over here. And as you can see, once again, you have the tiles. And these tiles will give more information. So maybe I wanna dress up as a T-Rex. You know, T-Rexes are fun. So we're gonna look through and we're gonna see the Tyrannosaurus. So we're gonna click that tile. As you can see, if I wanted to dress up as a Tyrannosaurus, you know, I have to be one of the scariest dinosaurs ever. You know, they say other dinosaurs had little chance against the T-Rex's snapping teeth and deadly claws. So if I was making my Halloween costume, I would need to make sure I have claws and sharp teeth. Once again, you'll just click the arrows at the bottom and that will show you more information. So we're gonna X out of that. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna scroll down and just to once again show you, you can see videos about dinosaurs. You can play some dinosaur games. You can read some dinosaur stories. You can see some dinosaur pictures. And you have some dinosaur activities. So like coloring pages, mazes, paint by numbers, fun things like that. So we're gonna scroll back up and we're gonna go back to the homepage right over here. So once we're in the homepage, there's a couple of things I want to go over before we head to our next part of World Book, is you're going to click videos over here. So for instance, if you want to watch videos, but you're not sure what you wanna see, you can click videos at the top and you can see there's one for people at work. But you know, maybe I wanna change it back to dinosaur. You just click the dinosaur at the top and you get videos about dinosaurs. If I wanna scroll to something that's not on here, just click the arrows in the corner. And like, for instance, I like the creepy crawlies. And so you click on that and more videos will show up. In terms of games, very similar. So we're gonna click on that second tab. For games, you can see that they are all listed under this section. And you can, once again, choose the type you want. So for instance, this one's true or false. We're gonna click the one with the pencil. This one is tracing. We're gonna click the last one with the tiles, and that's concentration. And so those are some games that you can play on this platform. The third tab that you can look at is on stories. So for instance, you can see like, for instance, the creepy crawlies, there's a rainforest adventure. But going back to the dinosaurs, maybe I want to read specifically only about dinosaurs. So I'm going to find the icon with the dinosaur, click it, and there's two that pop up right there. Same with people at work, you just click that, and you just can see all the stories that are listed under here. And then the last one is activities. Now, once again, you know, I know for myself, I like doing mazes. So there's mazes that you can check out, I spies, connect the dots, and all those fun things. So that was World Book Early Learning. Have you thought of some ideas of what you would like to dress up as? I know for myself, now, based on what we just talked about, I'm debating between being either a teacher or a T-Rex. Tell me in the comments which one you think I should be. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go back to our, when you clicked World Book Online on the Queen's Public Library website, this is, we kind of skipped this just a little bit before, we're going to go back to this other page. And so as you notice, before when we clicked Early Learning, this is the one we got. Now we're going to, now that we kind of have an idea of costumes, let's go look into about the history of Halloween. So for our, I would say, younger elementary kids, this is the part where you should definitely check out. We're going to click on the balloon that says kids. So when you're on here, now, for instance, your teacher says, I want you to research about Halloween and all the cool things related to it. This would be where you would go. Now, before we do that, I do want to just very quickly go over some of the things at the bottom. If you're interested in looking at pictures and videos, you can click this over here, and you can choose one of these to go into, to dig deeper and to learn about various things. So for instance, let's click authors, and you have pictures of all of these authors. And then once you click on one of them, you'll get an article about the person. You'll get a picture of the person. So if you're interested in just getting photos and looking at photos, what you're going to do is you're going to go to the photos area. Let me just make sure I get back. Yes. So you're going to click pictures and videos, and that's where you can find pictures. If you're interested in animals and articles about animals, you click World of Animals. If you're interested in some games, you're going to click activities. If you're like me and you love maps and you kind of want to see how maps have changed over time or maps related to specific history events, you're going to click maps and more. More games over here. These are going to be more game-esque. Activities is more like paint by numbers and things like that. But games is a fun area to go into. Comparing places is, once again, it's very similar to maps, but you can compare various areas. So for instance, you know, I'm from New York, but if I wanted to compare to, you know, New York with Texas, like what's the information that we can have for both places, this is where you'll look. If you're having a moment where you need to figure out some science projects you need to make, you just click science projects. And if you're interested in the meaning of a word, just click dictionary. Now, if you notice, I skipped over important people because I did want to go into that. Now, I know for some people, when they like to dress up for Halloween, they like to dress up as famous people. So this would actually be a great place to check out. So you're going to click on that magnifying glass, and you're going to see important people. And so you can either search for a specific important person, if you have one in mind, or if you say you're not sure who you want to look up, you know, there's so many different types of categories that we can take a look in. So for instance, we'll go into civil rights leaders. And as you can see, there's multiple articles about various civil rights leaders that you can look into, learn more about. And if you want to learn more, this is kind of that area where you will jump into. So let's go back, because I did want to talk a little bit more about the history of Halloween. And so in that case, what we'll do is we will click this search button. And so let's just start with Halloween. We're going to click explore. And once we click explore, what we're going to do is actually, hold on 1 second. We're going to click Halloween over here. And you see this magnifying glass over here? You're going to click the magnifying glass. As you can see, Halloween is the first article that pops up. So let's click on there. Now, as you can see, once we get here, we get into a whole article about what Halloween is. And you know, a lot of history, background information, and things like that. Now, when we're doing this, if you like to listen to something versus reading it, you can click this megaphone over here and it'll read the article for you. In terms of kind of these tabs at the top, article, this is the article. If you're interested in pictures, videos, and more, you can always click here. Especially when you're doing some more history-based articles, you're going to see a lot of maps and videos and things like that will also appear in this tab over here. And lastly, for more information, if you just click that, this is a really fun part where, for instance, if you are doing a project and you need more resources, right, to learn about, to reference in your paper, you can look at the websites here, and then the websites tab will give you other sites to take a look into. If there are related articles, they will also put it in this section over here. If you want to see activities related, so for this one, it's Halloween, you can make an animal mask. And if you're interested in questions of just where to start in thinking about Halloween, these are just some good pointer questions to start with. And so that's kind of how we do it for World Book Online. When you search for it, you'll get the article, but you can also look into pictures, videos, and more, as well as using that more information tab to really take a look into other websites that you can also go into. As you start getting older, you'll have to start mentioning some of the articles that you are using in your paper. So when you are looking for that, you just scroll all the way down, and where it says how to cite this article, you can choose whichever one you like. I am partial to MLA, but you can also use APA or Harvard, and these are all the ways to reference your article, this article in these other, in your paper. Now, lastly, so now for maybe some of our older kids, so maybe, you know, fifth grade and up, you know, there's also another thing, especially as your projects are starting to get more in depth, you can start actually clicking student over here. So this is more, I would say, for fifth grade and up, you know, middle school, starting to get into middle school, and especially when you're looking to get more in depth with your information. So we're going to click student over here. And very similarly, we're going to, as you can see, we're in this whole new platform. Now, in this platform here, what you're going to do is, you know, search for the topic that you're looking for. So we're going to search and we're going to go with Halloween. And we're going to click the little magnifying glass over here. And as you can see, the first article is Halloween. There are some related like jack-o'-lantern or October, but we're going to just stick with Halloween so you can see how it's similar and different from the World Book Kids version. So we're going to click read more. And as you can see, when we scroll down, this article is much longer. It's a little bit more in depth. So for instance, when they talk about some of the traditions for Halloween, this one goes a little bit more in depth of, for instance, costumes, jack-o'-lanterns, fortune telling, mischief night, and Halloween symbols. So this is, especially if you're looking into more information, this is kind of the place you would take a look into. When you scroll all the way at the bottom, you're going to see a little button that says how to cite this article. So if you need to reference this in your paper, you just click that and you're going to see it gives you MLA, APA, and Harvard again on how to cite it. Now, some other things I do want to mention with World Book Student is that when you are looking at the things over here on the side, these are like little tabs. When you click on one, it'll take you right to the specific section that you want. So for instance, Halloween around the world, Halloween customs and symbols. As we always say, trick-or-treating is one. It is a very popular one. And so we'll go back to introduction really quickly. And so also, once again, if you prefer to hear it versus reading it, you can click right over here on this orange box and it will read the article to you. The last thing I want to mention really quickly is that when you see you'll always see the title of your article here, and you'll see standards, media, and related. Now, the thing I want to mention is the related portion. So we'll click that. And you're going to notice that, for instance, if you wanted to look into more information about Halloween, you can either click books and I'll give you a couple of books to check into, magazine articles that you can take a look into in terms of related information. So for instance, if you're looking into more things, you would just click this related information area over here. And so that kind of gives a brief overview in terms of World Book. It's a really great resource in getting your papers done and also just learning about a lot of new fun things. And so I hope that this was a good starting point for World Book online. And so I hope you have a better idea of what you want to dress up for Halloween. Maybe learn, maybe take a look on World Book to see maybe some of the traditions that you can do today for this year's Halloween. So before we end today's program, the last thing I did want to cover is in relation to the TumbleBooks. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to go back to queenslibrary.org and we're going to go into TumbleBooks. Now, TumbleBooks, you do need to sign in as into your library account. So you just need to make sure you have a Queen's Library card. To do that, if you don't have one, you can take a look at this get an e-card portion at the top of the website and the instructions will be there. But in the meantime, to get to TumbleBooks, what we're going to do is we're going to click Books, Movie, and More. We're going to scroll down all the way to Digital Media Services. And we're going to go to eBooks. Now, once you're going to get to a new page, and you're going to see there's a bunch. So we have Overdrive, Access 360, Biblioboard, Hydra. And so the main one I want to focus on is TumbleBooks. And so I'm going to stop sharing my screen just for 1 second so I can log in. But we're going to go for TumbleBook Library for Kids first. So just give me 1 second. I'm going to stop my screen for a second so I can throw in my login really quickly. And so TumbleBooks is really great because one of the things it does have is that, for instance, if you prefer reading on your phone, there is an app available that you can use and you can download onto your various devices. And so definitely check that out. As you can see, there's three versions of TumbleBooks. We're gonna go into that really quickly in 1 second. But the first one we're gonna focus on is TumbleBook Kids. So this is more for our younger friends, and it includes things like picture books, includes early readers, intermediate readers, all that fun stuff. And so you should be back to seeing my page right over here. And so we're gonna scroll all the way down and we're gonna go to TumbleBook Library. So we're gonna browse the titles and let's make sure everyone can see. Perfect. So TumbleBook Library. So these are a lot of the books on here allow for you to really be able to, if you want to listen to the story, you're more than able to allow the books have that capability. So just scrolling down, they have, you know, various different topics and things that you can take a look in. So as you can see, they have one whole lists just for Halloween. They have new books and all of that fun stuff. Also, if you're like me and love graphic novels, this is a really good place to find graphic novels. And so as you can see, there's tons and tons of books. And so just to go over kind of like some of the similarities and differences, we do have one of the easiest ways to really look for things here is these tabs at the top. So for instance, we're gonna click the tab for storybooks. So we'll click that and you're going to notice there's a lot of picture books here available. So, you know, in terms of new books, let's go with Bailey. So we'll click Bailey. And as you can see, you have Bailey and you have a description, you have the grade level, the Lexile reader, and then you just click read online and then it'll pop up onto a new page. And it'll give you the ability to read the book online, but then also if you want to have the book read to you, it can do that too as well. Read-alongs are very similar. Read-alongs are for just a little bit older readers, for like early readers and starting chapter books. But once again, you have the option to click on it. For instance, we'll do Beware Pirates. When you read online, you have the option for the book to read to you. In terms of ebooks, when we click on ebooks, there's tons and tons of ebooks here. So for instance, we'll click on Tale of Despero. Tale of Despero is a great book. And so you're gonna see, once again, a description. You click read online. So in terms of these books, for the ebooks, what you might notice is that not all of them have the read back function. So these are more, once you start reading on your own, these are more of those types of books. Once again, you click at the top for graphic novels, as all of our favorites, Geronimo Stilton's up there. And so there's tons of graphic novels that you can read. So we'll click Geronimo. Once again, you'll see the description. You can click read online. And then we have nonfiction, works the same way. And we have videos. So for instance, if you want to watch a short video, like for instance on history or space and technology, this is where you would go. And then language learning is also, if you are learning other languages, this is a great place to also take a quick look at in terms of what's available. Now, for instance, if you're looking for a specific book, what you can do is you can click over here, Tumble Search in the corner. You click that, and there's various ways you can search. So you can search by title, search by author, search by subject. And so just because I do like this author, we're gonna say search by title, right? So let's do the Mercy Watson series. So we're gonna click Mercy Watson, you click go, and you're gonna notice that there's going to be several things that relate. So for instance, Mercy Watson, this playlist of a collection of their adventures. There's a video for here where the book will read to you once again. And as you can see, there's just various books and videos that will play, that will read Mercy Watson back to you. And so in terms of Halloween, I think Mercy Watson, Princess in Disguise is a perfect one for the Halloween spirit. And so the last thing I'm gonna cover before we end today's program is I'm just gonna very quickly just go over TumbleBooks for kids. And so just give me 1 second. Let me go back to the Queen's Library website. We're already logged in. So once again, to get to TumbleBooks, you click Books, Movies, and More, Digital Media Services, scroll down, and you're gonna click eBooks. And we're gonna scroll down once more. And we're gonna see TumbleBook Cloud Junior. So this one I just wanna mention, especially for instance, if you're like within that grade 3 to 6 age and you wanna start reading a little bit more challenging books, you can try TumbleBook Cloud Junior. You just click here for browse titles after you have signed into your library account. And then you're going to notice that it's set up pretty similar to the way that the other TumbleBook platform was set up, where you're gonna have eBooks, read-alongs, videos, audiobooks, graphic novels, and nonfiction. And so in terms of these, so for instance, you'll have eBooks. So when you have eBooks over here, these don't necessarily read back to you, but they are available for you to read online. In terms of the read-alongs, these read-alongs do allow for the possibility for the book to be read to you, which is always a fun thing. And videos and audiobooks. And once again, if you like graphic novels, this is a really great place to take a look for a few of them. In terms of searching, for instance, just as before, you can search by title, author, publisher, reading level, books with video, or Common Core. So I'm going to see one for Halloween costume. We're going to just type in Halloween costume. And then, so while there isn't a book that matches specifically to that query, which can sometimes happen, for instance, if you're thinking of something and you can't, and this comes up, what you can do is you notice on the side, on the left, so we see eBooks, read-alongs and videos, and this breaks it down a lot more. So for instance, you know, I wanted an eBook, but the Halloween costumes didn't show up anything. So let's go to some of these early readers. Let's take a look. And okay, so like some of these might fit in possibly. You just have to scroll through and look through a little bit more. And so these facets are really helpful when, for instance, if you're searching for something and something doesn't come up, this is another way for you to browse the ebook collection. And so, for instance, Bruno for Real, you know, Cheetah, Down the Chimney, these are all great books to take a look at. And so that pretty much covers my presentation today on World Book Online and TumbleBooks. So thank you everyone so much for watching today. I hope because, you know, Halloween is coming up very, very soon that you get your costumes all ready. I see a couple of people, some people said I should dress up as a T-Rex. And yeah, so maybe we'll go with T-Rex. And if so, just make sure that on Halloween that you stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful rest of the day. Thank you so much. Have a good one.